Hello everyone, and welcome to MAT170 Precalculus. This is a course introduction that is designed to get you up and running quickly and getting to be successful in this brief session of about 7.5 weeks. I'm Michael Littlecrow. I'm one of the instructors on the team of instructors working with this course. We've been redeveloping it over summer, and we will continue to do so with our team approach. So please, we need your input as students. We get the input of all the instructors. So what works from the instructor side, what works from the student side, we put that together to make a course that is flexible and beneficial for everyone. That's our goal. So let me get you started here. Let's go to our point of entry, the CAMIS course. So as you get into your Canvas course for fall, this is for the A session, but we'll see if it also works. We'll see if we make any changes for the B session. The most important things, there's a welcome here where you can find this video as well, and the syllabus. So I highly recommend going to the syllabus sort of right at the beginning as you open this up. Internet's a little slow, but it will give you all the details about the course in a printed form. And again, we wait and we're not able to load. Okay, so go to there first and then come back to the home. After you look over the syllabus, which I'll pull up later to give you that, the first thing you're gonna do is go to Alex. McGraw-Hill Alex. We're using Alex this semester. If you've taken Math 117, you may be familiar with the Alex system. However, we have made some adaptations to the adaptive learning portions of Alex. So this is the first point of entry. This will pair your Canvas course with the Alex course. Now, it's important that you get paired with the correct Alex course. So it's going to ask you if you've ever used Alex before, and you need to say no. And it's not a lie. I'm very much on honesty. It is that you've never used it with this particular Canvas course, because we want to pair this course with your Math 170 Alex course. So you'll click on there and it'll take you through. Let me show you, I've got the Alex course open. We're still working on getting everything set up. After a brief tutorial page, you'll come directly to here, and notice one of the things that you won't see is an initial knowledge check. We are relying that to get into this course, you fulfilled a prerequisite. You've either already taken 117 or you've tested into Math 170. So we are going to have you work through each of the objectives from the start. So when you get in here, once you go through the tutorial, you'll just start your path and you'll start working in the first two objectives. Okay, it's sort of like chapters. Where I'm gonna take you, is to the report section, to kind of what I'm going to give you is sort of an overview of where to find things. So the reports is a very important thing, and one of the best reports I have found as I worked through the course was looking at the current objective report. And if you look at the view full report, what this is going to do is it gives you the due dates on each of the objectives, what's in there. So the first one, Review Objective Part A, contains 13 topics. Now each topic will take you between 2 to 3 to more attempts at questions, question types, to have that objective marked as learned. So a minimum of 2. If you get 2 in a row right, it should be marking it as learned. It might take 3 on some occasions. But that topic gets marked as learned, and then you go to the next one. So there are 13 topics, question types for Objective A, and that is scheduled actually to start on the first day of the course. The second day of the course, the goal is for you to get through the 11 topics in Review Objective B. What these are at the end of the week, you'll see they're called sun points later. This will get into the core of the course, Intro to Functions, Objectives 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. So each day we have an objective. Now look, there's 9 credits here, 6, 8, and 9. Now, you might ask, what if I can't work every day? A goal is that you do a little bit each day, as much as you can. If you don't finish it on a particular day, there is no penalties, because the way we've set it up is there's a weekly due date of Sunday. That's why we call them sun points. Also, we're the sun devils, so I thought that was kind of a nice thing to call them, sun points for sun devils, and they get posted on Sunday. So the work you do, the lessons you learn are all also going to be counted here. So you'll see this as you work through these, you'll see this little wheel will also give you a total for the week. And your goal, of course, would be to get all 39 done. If you don't, you get the percentage. So if you get 30 done, you get the percentage of 30 out of 39, and that'll be your percentage. But the goal is that by that Sunday night, you get them all done. Now, that's the advantage of starting early, because once you finish those first two objectives, you will actually start being able to work on this. So if you can do things a little bit early, that puts you sort of ahead of the wave. Any surfers out there might know it's best to be, you ride the wave just a little bit in front so you have the momentum carrying you forward. So the same thing is here. If you can stay even just a little bit ahead, everything works much more smoothly. We also have a system at the end where you get, as long as you work through all of the topics, you will get some credit at the end. We call that a PI progress. And that's all in the syllabus, so I'll let you look over that. The goal of this one was to get you up and running and started. And until you do that, a lot of the stuff I would give you isn't going to make sense. So I want this one to be a short video, and I have a problem with brevity, so I'm going to pull back now. The two things you need to do. First thing, take a look at the syllabus real briefly, but very important, get your Canvas course connected to your Alex course. In fact, do that right away. Then it's done, and then you're officially in the course, right? Because that's what we're looking to, is this first few days in the course. By the Sunday, we need to have you in the Alex course, because then the grade books will sync properly, okay? And we know you're going to be committed to being the class. There's some information here. We do have something called Inscribe. So Inscribe is where you can, is a discussion forum where you can post questions and answer questions. And we'll talk more about all that kind of stuff later on. And then, for each of the objectives, we do have some instructional videos available. Sometimes they don't load quite properly, but if you click on the link, it will take you to the video. There's also notes for this objective. And again, my system doesn't seem to be loading. We'll see if it works or not. But there's some notes. So there's some printed notes. Please ignore the 2.1. They're connected to other things. But they give you some notes on the types of stuff that'll be there. And let's see what's going on here. I'll go back. And then there's videos, instructional videos. And then, so you've got this part of the course, this instructional part in Canvas. You do the work in Alex, and we'll make sure they all get synced in properly. Now, and then we come down here, 100 points, so that's up to the 100% for the sun points for week two. So that's the way it is. We've got this schedule here. This should, you'll see in the syllabus, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, each objective per day to keep you on track. But we trust you, and we need you to learn how to manage your time so that you're getting all this work done within the week, hopefully not all in one day, because it's really not designed to be a course that can be done in one day and that you would effectively learn. Okay, and then you'll see this course is algebra, and then all the way through unit 4. Take an exam. Call it a midterm if you want. We'll call it the algebra assessment because it's all algebra. After we finish that exam, about halfway through, we get into trigonometry. We will focus on trigonometry, and the last exam, the final exam, is a trigonometry exam. So there's really two courses in here, an algebra course, a trig course. We've got them together, and we're going to work together as an instructional team, listening to your voice on anything that you see and making adaptions and improvements to the course as we work forward. Thank you all. I wish you all the best of success. please be in touch. My email, if you need to get a hold of me for any reason, whether I'm your instructor or not, is michael.little.crow@asu.edu. michael.little.crow.